Cool.
I have literally no clue if anyone's gonna come on here.
Who knows? I don't like this though. I don't know if anyone's gonna be able to see this. Oh, I need a button of music. But
I am ready to go. So I will be doing my
fucking Instagram.
It's so stupid out here. Okay.
Moisturizer.
What have I been using? This first.
I don't really like seeing how much time this takes me.
Oh, so many glorious ceramides.
Oh my god. Hello. Someone's in here. Oh my god.
Hello.
What's going on? It's been madness today.
I'm just arranging my moisturizers. I'm gonna put on an oil.
So many moisturizers. This one. And then I'm gonna go get my globes. Why does it say I have a message, but don't? I don't know. I've been really liking this oil. My skin feels so soft. Oh, more of that, please. I can what? What? So annoying.
Okay. Globes. I wonder how long I'll be blocked.
That's so stupid. I don't know if chat, oh God, hi. Yeah, I don't know if chat works, so if you are chatting with me, please. I don't know anything about this type of life. But hello, it's good to see you. Instagram's so annoying, guys. I am just out here. You know what it is? Because I like commented on my friend's post. I was like, LOL, fuck me. Because they were like taking pictures of me and I didn't know. And then I get a little notice from Instagram. It's like, you're not allowed to say that. And I was like, who cares? And I'm pretty sure that's what did it. So if I just have to go somewhere else, I will. Yeah, I know that. Like, honestly, whatever. IG's just a monster. But I'm just gonna be out here because I gotta go to a meeting. I just got, like, IG just literally was like, you're not allowed. You're temporarily suspended. Because I literally commented on my friend's post being like, LOL, fuck me. I just think that they are such prudes lately. Even more prudish than normal. More prudish than TikTok usually is. TikTok's so prudish. So, like, what the fuck? It's cool. I'm gonna show you guys my new sunscreen technique. Because I want to. And also, I think it's working. So fire. I'm also going to use one of these. This lip oil. I know. Okay. My hands are completely too greasy to open this right now. Okay. So this was the one that sounded the best smelling to me. I'm not really a fruity girl. I'm not super fruity. I'm just not super fruity when it comes to like scents, but the passion fruit coconut sounds good. Look at this doe foot. I love that. This is the Milani lip oil I just got yesterday. This doe foot, oh my God. It's like a jelly and a lip oil had a baby. It has such a nice feel. Ooh. I like it. Okay, sunscreen time, but I'm gonna mix it with this one. I did this where I put this all over my face, which was bronzy, but I just kind of want to mix them and see what I get. So let's do it. What I'm gonna do is do a whole finger of my pipette on my forehead, but then I'm also gonna do a little baby pump of this one, because if you haven't heard about this one, it's tinted. The tinted SPF that is mineral. So it will completely mitigate the white cast, but also give you a bronzy look. So I'm just gonna like kind of spread it and then take this with it and see if the mix of them does something that I like. I actually already like it because it's rubbing in so nice on my face. Look at that. Okay. You know I have to do a crap load of SPF on my forehead. So that's where I'm the most intrigued. But the formulations of both kind of have a similar finish on the face. So in theory, they should mix really well together. Like they kind of both feel the same. Where's my cap? I just dropped my cap. Excuse you. Come back to me. Are you lost forever? Oh, God. And I look insane. Okay, we're just gonna find that cap in a second. This is with the new nude screen, Nude Sticks Nude Screen. And this is the shade Tint Warm. So they have one that is white, but they have tinted ones as well. Oh my God, I'm loving this. I don't even feel like I have to go in with the Bionic Bronzer now. What do you guys think? This looks so nice. Oh my God, that mixed so nicely. Where's the cap to this so I can put it away? I swear, I would lose my head if it wasn't attached to my body. You went under my bed. No. What? Doesn't it look nice? I think it looks great. I don't know. It's like literally lost forever, guys. Okay. It's cool. I'm really happy with this product. I'm like so excited to have it in my life. Like that just looks like my skin again. It's not like I have to feel like I'm having my freaking whitest face ever, you know? This is a game changer. This is such a game changer. I'm so excited. Why don't the chats just stay up? It's so weird. Okay. So now that we have that on, I can prime. I'll do my pre-game primer from Youthphoria that I love. Love it so much. Technically, I'm perfectly primed. I don't need this step, but I love it because I don't do coverage all over the face. So especially if I have blush and bronzer on, it kind of has something more girthy to stick to than just my regular skin. I kind of think of this as almost like an invisible foundation in part. And I love this one because it just feels like skincare. It just feels like another skincare step. My skin looks so good. Fuck. Okay, let's add auric. The pregame primer you just ordered? Oh my God, that's dope. I love that brand. I think they're doing cool things. I think they're gonna keep doing cool things. So look at my eyes on them. Dude, it really didn't. Like, it's so pretty. And they have a darker one for darker skin tones. Like, it's really nice. It makes me want to try like a mineral white zinc on a deep skin tone, mixing with their tinted ones and seeing how that works. Oh my God, I'm so excited for you. You're gonna love it. The brand is great. They're so cool. Oh, Nude Sticks. Let me find it. Nude Sticks. It's brand new. This just came out, so I'm not even sure if it's available yet. Keep your eyes peeled. Go. You could probably find it on Instagram. I'm gonna finally unbox something. Oh, so happy. I have this back in my life. This is a great setting spray, but I love it as a prep mist. Love it. Emma, you're a fucking killer boss. Oh my God, that's a great idea. Yeah, they do have the minis, so that's incredible. Okay, so primed under eyes. Let's just do Jones Road. Where you at? Where you at, little pencil? For such a small pencil, it's lasted me so long. Like, I still have a ton of product left. I sat down with someone from Wildcat yesterday. We had dinner. and we had such a nice time. I went to this place in Long Beach. We went to Long Beach, which I just never hang out in Long Beach, but Long Beach is so cool. Very cool neighborhood of LA, but it's just kind of like off the beaten path from LA direct. It's like 20 miles from where I live. But it's so cool there. And Amanda took me out to this place called Little Coyote, and it was so amazing. I just want to go back. I want to hang out there again. I'm like, let's keep hanging in Long Beach. I'm going to take my best friend there once she comes to town. Okay. And I think we're going to do this baby all over. But yeah, I have an interview today, like a meeting interview. They're interviewing me for, I think, like a dissertation kind of vibe. I'm intrigued. I love helping academics out. It's like so fun for me. So I hope it's good. The best part about me not having to pre-bronze is I don't have to do coverage in places where I'm just trying to knock back the bronze. Oh my god, I always forget how much pigment this concealer has. Yeah, because when I was pre-bronzing, I was kind of having to like knock it back. But now that I'm just back to my regular color, I can do whatever I want and just do really translucent skin. So that is the new technique, my friends. I just want translucent looking skin, but still, you know, evened out. I love this concealer. It's incredible. They really did this one right. Like these guys on my forehead are just dry. I have like one kind of popping through there. Gonna take the tiniest bit more. And then maybe just a little bit more under my eye. I like the Jones Road, but it really doesn't, you really can't bump up coverage with it. It gives you just like medium and that's it, which is cool. I like that, but I do like something that's a little bit more not flexible, but just you get more options from something. I like something to be light, medium, and full, just depending on how much I use or placement or whatever. That's just typically like more something I'm interested in. Let's use my brightener under the eye because that always makes me look like I don't have any makeup on. This is seriously my everything. I had a call with Pacifica yesterday talking about plans for the next few months, and they're like, okay, is there anything you want us to send over? I was like, I need more brightener. And they're like, oh, I think we still have it. I was like, so I have a feeling they're gonna get rid of it, and I'm not well. I don't feel well concerning that. I feel wrong. So if you like this product, you've seen me use it, I 100% recommend picking it up. You have to while you can. I'm freaked about it. I forgot to add this. I hate when I forget that eye primer. Well, there's a mean little dog outside. Oh, God. He's just pissed. He's pissed. So I'm just going to take a brush because usually I like to use my finger and really work it in, but when you have concealer on, it's not the best. Oh my God. It just sounds like a little witch dog. Hi. Yeah, I know. I know. Believe me. I mean, I've been trying to get out of the IG anyways because they're fucking with things, so we might be YouTube people. There's no other platform I like as much. That's the fucking problem. But IG's full of fuckery. So I don't know. Don't know what to do. And they're like so much more prudish than they ever were. Like they're so prudish. Like, who cares? Do you hear this dog? He sounds like the devil. Okay. I'm definitely gonna go on stories tomorrow and do a complexion update because I think I've cracked my SPF. I'm just like so excited about it. So happy. Okay. Dude, my neighbors do have like super annoying dogs. I'm not gonna lie. There's one that's like very old that lives near me and I'm just like, oh my God, he's gonna kill us all. Of course. Psh, of course I'll let you know where I am at. I will always for sure. Highlight. I think I'm gonna use the Moonbeam from M in the cushion packaging. Yeah. This is the shade Halo. Oh my God, that dog. It's just a morning. It's just a morning today. So I really like these. These are such a thin liquid highlight formula. I love how they look, but I do like to top them with a balm to kind of melt them more directly into the skin. So that's what I'm gonna do. But that's not even a lot. Like I just don't, I hate cushion packaging. I hate it so much. It's to me a ridiculous form of packaging. It makes no sense why you would pick this over something else. It's such a wasteful componentry and it literally soaks up product. Oh my God, I know. Can I turn up my music? It's a morning today, guys. Thank you for hanging with me. Thank you so much. What the fuck? Okay, I'm gonna use the Face Cuddle from M because these work like so well together. And this is just a clear balm. He's pissed. Ugh, that just melts it into the skin. I can't get over that. And now I can regularly bronze. I can do whatever I want. I love that for me. So this is Clove and Hallow Toasted. I mean, this is my OG cream bronzer, my favorite. This Eco Tools brush is so incredible. I don't. I sent a request to them a long time ago, and I don't know if they'll ever fulfill it, but everyone I know loves the brand. Like, they love the brand. So I'm very intrigued by them. Ugh, I know. I can't wait to share it with you guys. He's having a temper tantrum meltdown. This is why I'm just not a dog person. Like, I love dogs, but every dog I meet, and my friends all have dogs, they all have one thing wrong with them. They all, and I'm sure all pets do, but I think with dogs, it's just so much more prevalent because they have such personality. and they make it so apparent. Like, I was hanging with my friend last night from Wildcat, and she has a pug, and this pug is so mean. Ooh, cool. I want the contour stick. But it was just so mean to, like, every freaking person we pass, and it liked me well enough, but I was just like, every dog has a fucking personality. Toasted. Toasted is my color. And obviously not all dogs are like that. Like, you have the friendliest dogs ever, but you risk more, I think, when you're like, I'm gonna get a dog as a pet versus like a cat. A cat, like, sure, it might be a little bit of a dick to people, but that's like very expected. I think with dogs, you're just like, I want you to love me. I want you to love me. I just want you to be a lover, you know? We're gonna use heliotrope. These baby hairs are so insane. Heliotrope. This picking blush, I could wear it only. Small dogs are I think that's definitely the case. Most of my friends have small dogs, and they're either riddled with anxiety or just grumpy. I believe that socialize when they're young, that makes a lot of sense. I'm gonna use a new blush today. On top of this, I should have actually used Magic Hour underneath it, but whatever. We'll see how they look together. I believe that. You're making so much sense. This is another nude sticks, and this is a shade that I've never tried. This is Picante. Look at her. That is orange. No, that's even more orange than I thought. Okay, well, I actually am happy that I put Heliotrope down, because I would like to see how these two kind of mesh together. I think this is gonna be good. I'm gonna take this brush. Let me buff it out. These are great, because this is their Nudies. Oh, this is their matte formula. Never mind. I thought it was gonna be their Bloom formula, which is a very dewy blush, but this is their matte formula. So it will definitely kind of dry down. Oh, this is nice though. I just kind of definitely thought it was gonna be more red. Wow, this is the orange blush. If you have ever wanted an orange blush, I think this is the most orange I've ever found. And mixed with Heliotrope, I love this. I don't know if I would wear this so by itself. Wow. She's an occasion. She's an occasion. I don't know if I would wear that all the time, but I do like how it looks. I'm very happy with how it looks. I'm happy to wear it. It's definitely not something I would pick for myself all the time. I would honestly put this on a medium skin tone in a heartbeat. Like, oh my god, that would look so fire. But on me, it's orange, which is fine. It's very cool. Let me get my Bare Minerals powder out. I think that's what I'm gonna use. Original Mineral Veil. Yes, so summer. No, this is like a great summer color. And spring, yeah, of course, but I definitely think of this for like summer. This on the lips too. Oh, that's when I really get into like orange lip stuff, is summer. Peaches. Yeah. I love this powder from Bare Minerals. Why is it so nice? What were you gonna say? Why is it so nice? Oh yeah. It's so nice. I love this powder. Like, it's an OG classic for a reason, I guess, but sometimes you just like forget. And there's just so much that comes on the market that you're just like, I don't really want to go back to the classics. But then you try it and you're like, yeah, there was nothing wrong with this. It was always nice. Very good. Very good. Let me melt the blush back in a bit more. This area has such bad, weird pigment. Okay, eyes. I'm not doing anything exciting, so let's do that. I might use the new Milani stuff tomorrow in stories on IG. Permitting, I'm allowed to post on stories. I know. I'm seeing brands like put more of an emphasis on slow beauty, which I don't think people like that terminology, but they have their minds in a different place. But more intentional beauty, where it's just like we're making amazing products, we're making like one at a time. And like two, maybe two products a year, right? Like for me, what, doesn't that sound way cooler? Like I love how Oric does it, like Sam's brand. They literally just really take their time on their products to come out with something amazing. And it stays amazing. And everyone goes apeshit for it. And then they sell it throughout the whole year. It's not like they just are like, it's a limited launch. That's all you get. It's like, no, that's still available. You can pick it up whenever you want. So I just wish more brands would get on that. Or it kills it. All right. So I do want to play with some stuff on the eyes. I have this pencil from Milani that looked really nice. This is the new one in, I have absolutely no idea, but it's kind of like too pewtery for what I want today, but I do really like that. Definitely gonna serve a purpose soon. Do I just want to wear Phytosurgeons? I might just wear Chilled Cherry. It's so good, guys. It's so good. I think I am gonna work a crease shadow in prior. Let me use, really? I mean, I take like a dense brush. Maybe you need to break the seal, warm it with your finger. But I mean, I take a dense brush. There's lots of product on there. I don't have any issues. But maybe you want to warm it up first with a finger. That might be beneficial. It's so good. So I am going to use just a little bit of a taupe crease with the espresso palette I use all the time. I'm just going to use that really quick. It might just need some warmth, honestly. Like, the warmth of your finger does more than you think. For sure, for sure. And yeah, especially I think if you're in a cold area, that can happen. Like, it can get a little harder to work. Or just if it's a new product, you might want to, like, give it a little bit of your warmth energy. But I love them. They're so creamy and good. Out of my eye. This next week's gonna be pretty busy starting out. Tomorrow I'm on set. Monday I'm shooting with Alex. Take your shopping break. It will be here. I think especially their Weathered Woods collection is not limited edition. Dude, the shimmer is everything. They're great. They're so cool. They're so cool. They're just such a cool brand. What was I saying? Okay, yeah. So I'm on set tomorrow. Filming with Alex on Monday. I'm doing Alex Anele's. I think it's Anele. Her last name. I've been saying Anel this whole time because it's like a cookie. So I just automatically assumed it was like the cookie. Or it's a pastry or something. I think it's a pastry. Anyway, I'm doing her makeup on Monday. And then I'm actually doing my own project on Tuesday, which I'm really excited about. God, I hope it works out. Sometimes things just fall apart, but I have been sitting on a project for a long time that I need to do. I need to paint it on someone. And I finally had like one of my really good model friends agree to help me out, which is great. That's like one of the worst parts is asking the models to be like, can you just come through and let me paint you? Because they get paid to do that. And I don't want to like take advantage of their time. Thanks, babe. It's just hard. Like, if it was like a look that I've always done, like it's like not so much of a risk. And I'll be like, come through, you're gonna love it. But because this is a look that like is new, it's a risk for models to show up and like even like it. But that's why I went with someone who I trust and know, and she likes me a lot, and she's just down to hang out no matter what. So I really hope I like it. I really hope everyone likes it. Okay, I'm gonna take Chilled Cherry. I'm just gonna use that brush I was using. And start working this all over into the crease as well. This can get like really pinky really quick. So that's why I like having a bit of that neutral taupe down before even having this down. And I'm just working it all through the eye. So good. Take a little blender. I still feel like I want to bring it up a little higher. Whatever's left on my brush. Oh my God. Such a good color. Maybe I do want to bring a color into the crease to kind of make it really pop. I might. I'm gonna get a smaller brush and just go under the eye with it. I always have like all my brushes in my hand. It just makes it so much easier. Yeah, it's so good. Chilled Cherry is popular for a reason. I think it's just like a hair neutral
more than the others. I feel like those are very cool toned. They're so pretty. Okay, I'm gonna throw another color into the crease.
I think I do want that. Give me a sec to find one that I'm in love with.
Oh my God, perfect. I'm gonna use this one from the Nosta palette, the Nosta Nostalgia palette. I'm just gonna add Gone, which is almost like a rose quality to it, but it's still just a brown, like a soft brown, and I think that's gonna look good. I really don't want this to lean pink, which is the undertone of the shadow. Just kind of more like a warm neutral taupe shimmer. I'm just kind of like swirling the brush all around. Is that giving what I want? It's okay. I might add like a plum liner to my lash line, like plum shadow or something, and that would be cool. What if I did this? I'm gonna add this. Like the touch of it, like the touch of it. But then I'm gonna immediately go into Gone. That was it. That was the move. Have you guys ever mixed eyeshadows like this? It's very easy. And you get a whole new world of color. Just start small like I did before you make big changes. Perfect. Cute. Taking a brush. That was the move. I'm gonna add just a bit more of this. Maybe in like a wider scope, I'm gonna just take a bigger brush. My favorite Sephora's Art Eye Buffer brush, and just kind of bump this up a bit. Good. This is the best brush ever. Yes. How am I doing on time? I'm good. I have an hour before I have to be at my meeting, which is like very close by. Let us do a little bit of plumminess to the lash line, just a scotch. And I will put down like a brown pencil first. Let's use Firewood from Play. These are very pigmented, so I don't need a lot. They will stretch out farther than you think. I'm gonna buff that brush that had Chilled Cherry in it. I do really like these pencils, they're very good. I still think I'll pick Milani over them any day. Totally, I will. But let me take a little bit of a teeny brush, and then I'm gonna grab Natasha Denona Bronze in this shade Deep Dive, which is like a dark, rich brown, but it has a lot of plum to it. So it's going to kind of go in really well with this.
and bringing it all across the lash line, but especially the outer corner. Good. Awesome. Come through. I'm gonna add just a touch of rhodium, I think. Let's see. Yeah, just in the center. Cause it has almost like that taupey quality, but also a little of that purpley. Still OG palette for me. Still bomb. I think I'm gonna do brows similarly to how I did them yesterday with the half-caked fluff brow. Get fluffed in three, shade three. I think this was the winner of the brow battle yesterday. Gen C actually reached out to me and they were like, I think you're right. We do need to add like another shade because the owners are right between one and two. And I was like, yeah, it's your brand. If you have don't have a color for yourself, what? It's very bushy. Wow. It's like the bushiest I've ever seen my eyebrows look with just a tinted gel. Wow. And this is like, what, like $8? Let's see. I gotta drink my coffee, guys. Get fluffed, half caked. This is the half caked fluff gel. $9. $9 for this. Insane. If you're looking for a Kosas airbrow dupe, that might actually be even a little bit better. My brows don't look like this when I use Kosas. No, they don't. So, happy gab. Let's fill them in. See what we get. I only used it on this eyebrow yesterday, so I haven't tried it on this eyebrow, which is my problem child eyebrow. Thank you.
It looks really good. Like, the tail of my brow never looks this fluffy. And it really does with this. I'll still clean it up. But I love how, like, wild and fluffy they look. Ooh! I might be able to do my regular playlist. Should we try it? Dude, it really fluffed them up. It's fluffy. Play some good music. This is my instrumental music. This is my regular daily mix, number one. The music I actually listen to. I don't know, I can go live here or I can go live on this platform called Moonus. But that requires a schedule, which is the only thing. And I don't like schedules. So I definitely have to like get that in my head. But would you guys rather see me do live like here or on like a live platform like Moonus? I mean, it's only a couple of you, but please tell me. Cause like, what the fuck? It's been twisted for ages. Dude, is it? This is fine. So, are all of you experiencing this video quality being bad, or? Moonus is great. I like them. But like, I've never really used them much because Instagram has a built-in live platform. But I have gone live on there before and it was really nice. Video quality looks good for you. Okay. Maybe it's a connection thing. I'm just using my darker color brow gel just to give me a little extra definition. Okay, okay. Well, I'm gonna have to go back to IG and be a good little girl, which is really hard for me. I like to be filthy and just be allowed to be filthy. I said, lol, fuck me, on my friend's photo because she took a picture of me from behind. And I was like, lol, fuck me. Oh my God, I had no idea you were taking a picture of me. And they blocked me. Yes. Yes. And I've been having people in my lives be like, bitch, oh my God. And then they get flagged because they're saying bitch. They're not saying like, fuck you, bitch. Like, it's stupid. Stupidity. Okay, let's clean up the brow, and then I will use my Patrick Ta to really make sure things don't move around on me. Even though I just feel like this has such good hold on it. I still need, like, a clear gel to kind of just make sure. When did Instagram turn into, like, a platform for infants? I don't understand. I have a friend who worked for Meta. Maybe I shall text her. I feel like that's kind of weird. Like, hey girl, could you like unblock my page if you have that power? They're just like, TikTok gets away with it. We want to be like TikTok. It's like, no one wants you to be TikTok. We have separate entities for a reason.
The one thing about this style is it does, like, a lot of brow hairs don't fit in the shape that I go for. Okay, so now we take the Patrick Ta. This is where things can either go really right or really wrong. You want to just go back and then go back through the front. And it will stay in this shape that you put it in all day. We're just living in a man's world, you know? Still. It could be worse. We could live in Russia. We shouldn't complain too much, I guess. I still will, though. Why not? Okay, I'm gonna use my pen just to kind of fill in any spots. I love the brow. Don't get me wrong, I still love a soap brow look, but this is just so much more natural. These look like my eyebrows, you know? I know. Fuck you guys. Not you guys. Men. Let's do mascara. We're gonna do brown mascara today because it's my joy of life. This is frustrating, you know? Like, as women, we're so much smarter. And we don't have any fraction of control over the world that men do. What is up with that? How is that possible, you know? And we kind of allowed it, you know? Like, we were just ready to lay down for men back in the day. Back in olden times, when we could have had power, we just like listened to the church, honor your husband vibes. I mean, we're talking old times, but set a precedent for our age today. Okay, CoverGirl Uncensored first. I'm so drippy this morning. What's the deal? Is it too late? I don't think it's too late, but we have to be organized. I know, the Vikings are badass. I don't know if it's too late, but we have to absolutely make a fucking plan. Is that what's the deal? I'm not allergic to anything, to my knowledge. But yeah, the seasonal changing. That's the problem. It's just been so many years of one way. Fucking true. Ooh, I'm excited by that show. Okay, I'll watch it. We were talking about The Norsemen, this movie coming out next month. I think it was either yesterday or the day before. And I'm real excited by that because it's by, like, my favorite director. It seems really good. He's the same guy who did Lighthouse and The Witch. I'm definitely gonna watch this Valhalla show. My friends were really addicted to Vikings. I just never got into it. Last Kingdom. Okay, I'm gonna use my Clover mascara now. The movie looks so good. Oh, God. I don't know where we lost. I don't know where we lost power, but it was definitely the rise in Christianity. Because men took it and they were like, this is how the world should be, and we're going to basically be missionaries all over the fucking world and preach our ways and freak everyone out and run things by fear and get everyone to follow our ways. Religion definitely made everything worse. Dark is after dawn. I opened a new tube of this and it is fresh. Oh, absolutely. So much fear mongering. Everyone just wants to rule through fear. Why can't we rule through love? We're just women. What do we know? Kill me. This is one of the reasons I can't settle down with men. So hard for me. I honestly feel like I would fall in love with someone trans or... Hi, babe. Aw, hi. I don't know, just something different, like off the beaten path. Just not a super straight man. Like what, Emma? I'm going for a snatch nose. Let's see if it works. You get it. Dude, Finland? Killing it. I fucking agree with that. Can we move there? Let's move there. They need us. I think they need us. Okay, you see how, like, fucking snatched this is? It's definitely not gonna look this way the whole time, but we have the foundations for it. Everyone gets silenced who doesn't follow what they want the media to be dictated as, which sucks because that's like such a Republican thing to say. Oh, the media, like fake news. Like, it's sometimes true because there is a control over the narrative. It's amazing with a war going on that COVID is disappearing. Straight white dudes are terrible. Let's just end it with that. You guys, we're just gonna use YouTube Live as our like coven of plotting the demise of men in power. It's the fear mongering for me that just kills me. Because. Okay, see, Laura, people are saying it's fine, but then, yeah, some people are saying it's blurry, so. Might be connectivity things. Ugh. I'll be back on IG, I promise. Stupid, though. We could use this. We could use this as our fucking playing ground. We're so close to being done. So close. My blush was orange today, so I kind of want to bring it away from being super orange. Do you hear this out here? Ooh. Yeah. I fucking love this blush from Play. This is Pure Bliss. And it's Pure Bliss. And it's just like the most pretty, soft pink. Yeah! Oh, thank you for the tips, guys. I still wear a mask on set because I'm in people's faces and I feel like that's appropriate. But believe me, when I'm out here, just like, I just have never had COVID. I've never had COVID. No one I know has had COVID besides my family who doesn't even live here. None of my friends here have had it. So it's been kind of frustrating, I'm not gonna lie. Just, you know, I mean, obviously I'm glad I didn't get COVID, but it's just like, I put 2 years of my life on pause and I didn't even have the repercussions, you know? I'm happy about the masks. I'm happy about it. Let's do a lip. I have two options from Milani. Yeah, I think that's what I want to try. Yeah. I think I want to use... Let's see. You guys want to pick for me? I am glad I didn't get it. Very glad. But I've always had a very good immune system. I just never really get sick. You could say maybe like lighter or darker. Number one. Lighter. Lighter. Okay, let's just do it. Let's just do it. This one is the new Milani lipstick in Peony. Let's see what we get. They smell so good. Oh, I love it. I love it. It's so cute. No, I really like this. Milani is upper crust, high tier extra of the freaking drugstore industry. I love Petus. We don't. We do, but we don't. We do, but we don't. I'm done, guys. I'm done. Thank you so much for hanging with me on YouTube. I'm gonna use this. I know that the video quality is like a little off for you guys. So I'm not saying this is a forever solution. But I don't know how long I'm gonna be temporarily blocked. So check stories tomorrow. I'll be keeping updates. I really like the new lip oil. I tried it today. This one in Passion Fruit Coconut. Love it. Well, I'm down to keep doing it here. We'll see how it goes. We'll see how it goes. But I absolutely am going to be in stories tomorrow because I'm going to be showing off my complexion routine that we did today. Or at least something like it. Because I have cracked the fucking SPF game. So I have to share it with you guys. At least, okay. I always forget this nostril. I absolutely will. Of course I will. I'm going to be looking into newness as well. So we will not let lives die ever. I don't think ever. But I'm just frustrated because all my babes are on IG. So it's like, ugh. But we will fix it. We'll figure it out. I still want to be a disgusting boy, you know? I want to say terrible things if I want. I want to say fuck. I want to say bitch. I want to say ass. Like, fuck you. Whatever. Also, do you guys like my nails? I'm really happy with them. Major Matrix dystopian energy. I hope it's a short band too. Okay. Bye, guys.